Well, greetings from the sales floor of Ellingson Motor Cars here in Rogers, Minnesota, the home to close to 100 classic and collectible cars. And today we're going to talk about our latest acquisition, a 1935 Ford Model 48 Deluxe Roadster. Talk about a really rare car. I'll give you the details in a minute. Well, greetings from the sales floor of Ellingson Motor Cars here in Rogers, Minnesota, the home to close to 100 classic and collectible cars ranging everywhere from the 1920s, 30s, all the way up to the late models and roadsters, collectible cars, muscle cars, resto mods, you name it, we've got it in stock. Take a look at all of our cars at www.ellingsonmotorcars.com. For our latest acquisitions, newest arrivals, and current cars in inventory. But today we're going to talk about what I think is a really, really special car in that you very seldom see the Deluxe Roadster. This is a really, in 1935, Henry Ford, Edsel running the company, was the president of the company in 35. This was their pride and joy, and that V8 Ford motor was taken off like crazy. People were finding out that it was a hotshot motor and could really, really run out well. Actually, they produced over 2 million of those motors in 1935. That's when they hit that mark. So a lot of those flatheads were out there, and the 35 Ford is just one of these really nice examples right here with the dark green color with the candy green wire wheels. It really stands out, does it not? Take a look from your stand back. Got the wire wheels, the V8 hubcap, of course, in the middle, then the wide whites. This car was really special in 1935. And, the cost was about $550, give or take. It was one of the more friendly cars in terms of a person's budget, if that's what you're looking for, in 1935. And Ford was taking the market by storm, even during the middle of the Depression. But, lots of neat things. They changed some stuff on the Fords in 1935. We've got the headlights that have the matching paint, the bumper guardettes, of course. The new hood sides, that was for 1935. Trying to just get it a little changeover from the louvers that you had in the 33 and the 34 Fords. And, again, this was one of those cars that was reasonably priced. A lot of people could enjoy it. They could afford to buy it. And the reason it was really special is it did even have the rumble seat. In this particular car, you have a rumble seat. It always never ceased to amaze me that they got in and out of these cars, in the middle of winter anytime, and they got these little step plates that you step on the bumper and then on the fender and whatever. No wonder paint didn't survive very well. Guess what? It's really nice on this one. But I've just always thought that was something that they had to actually get in the back seat. But you can take the back window down, since this is a convertible canvas top, the back window does go down. So if you had someone in the back that you wanted to talk to, that was an easy way to do it and still have the comfort of having the canvas top right here. You look at it, it's got the banjo steering wheel, all original instrumentation in this car yet. No one has cobbled it up, if that's the word we want to use, or changed it from the way it came in 1935. This car actually even has in place, can't tell you necessarily if it works, but it has an original radio. That was a pretty rare item in 1935. Not very many radio stations to be found at that time. Beautiful running boards. And again, I just really like that the wheels just set this car off just really, really well. Nice interior, all been redone. This car was really well restored. We've looked at the floor pans and whatever, and it's really nice and clean. This is not a rusty car. It's very neat. You also, of course, you still have the front windshield that will open up to give you, quote unquote, your air conditioning, and you can open the vent as well. Just gives you a little more. We'll start this thing up for you in a little bit, and you'll be able to have a nice walk around, see more details of the car. That's really a nice thing to do, so want to watch to the end of the video. You can also find all of our cars on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Give us a like, leave us a comment, or subscribe. We appreciate it, and you'll find interesting cars that we've had in the past, interesting stories, things that'll just tickle your fancy if you've got time to look on the internet and you're just perusing. I think you'll find it enjoyable. But yeah, this is really one of those neat cars. The ride in the rumble seat is a really special thing for people. And this actually even has the spare tire cover in the back. and a luggage rack. Well, when you think about it, there's no real trunk if you have a rumble seat. So they had an accessory that you could have a trunk. You would have to get a trunk, of course, but that's how you traveled. If you went across country, were traveling, going someplace, you'd have to put your suitcases out in the back. Again, just one of those interesting things to note. I think this car also has, yes, it does. It has dual taillights. I always liked that. That was just, you know, that was kind of an option. But again, this is a deluxe model, so you got the chrome windshield. They didn't even make a standard in the convertible like this in the Roadster. But yeah, just a really neat old car all the way around. It would be so much fun to go on a nice summer day, put the top down, and go cruising. If you want to come and take a look at this in person, hey, we'd love to have you come down to Ellingson's. We're open Monday through Friday from 10 until 5 and Saturdays as well, 10 to 4. Come on down. We'd love to have you take a look. This is an all-steel one. This is not any kind of hot rod deal in terms of whatever. This is the way Edsel Ford and Henry had it produced in 1935. Great example. If you're looking to add to your Ford collection, want your first old car, the old flathead V8 is just a wonderful motor, lots of parts availability. They even had aluminum heads in 1935. They had a little more performance, just to, like Henry said, this was starting to be good guys and bad guys like this fast motor. The cops enjoyed this car because they had the flathead V8 was a good pursuit car, and so did the criminals as well. So anyway, it's a very neat one. Come on down, take a look. We'd love to show you around. Take a look at this one and many of our other ones that we have in stock. So we will see you next time. Thanks for visiting.